Many lessons ago, we've talked about how to develop the public interface of a class, the methods that one might want to call on objects of a class, but we've always pretty much given to you the instance variables, because it turns out that picking the right instance variables isn't all that simple. Well, now the time has come for you to do more of that yourself, and I'd like to give you a few rules of thumb on how you might discover instance variables. To see how those rules of thumb work, let's have another look at the car class from lesson 3. That class had an instance variable to hold the amount of gas in the tank. There was a method to add gas where the parameter value would be added to the gas in tank. Now the point that I want to make is there is a certain pattern here. You have a quantity here. Here you make that quantity bigger. It also gets smaller when the car is driven. I like to call that pattern keeping a total, and it occurs in many classes, not just the car. So there are lots of times where you have some class and you have some variable, which may be called total or not, and then there's some methods that add to the total, maybe some methods that clear the total or subtract from it. I'll give you a few situations and I'll ask you whether the pattern of keeping a total applies. So would you keep a total to model the account balance in a bank account, friends in a social network, a car odometer, stripes in a flag? Check all where you think the pattern makes sense.